Namaste, sir. And he was very keen on talking about the parents' role in this, because that is very, very important. As I said, the parents are more paranoid than anybody else. So over to you, Abdul sir.
गुड मॉर्निंग गुलशन शर्मा जी, स्नेहा जी एंड पैनलिस्ट, ऑल माय टीचर्स हु आर वाचिंग दिस प्रोग्राम, माय सन, आई एम एक्सट्रीमली हैप्पी टू हैव बीन इनवाइटेड एंड आई ओ यू नो दिस ऑनर टू गुलशन शर्मा जी एंड आई एम अमेज्ड एट हिज एनर्जी एंड more than that is memory. I don't even remember these names in Kerala. Thank you so much, Sharma ji, to help me, share this wonderful platform. I'll come to the topic about parents' role. We were discussing. The situation is alarming, as everybody knows. 6.3 million people are infected and more than 1 lakh people killed in India. We are dealing with 300 million students as well. And it's a huge responsibility, from the part of educators. Though we have been given, protocols, SOPs from the concerned ministries. As experience says, we should not rush. This is what I have to advise parents, because the situation is not at all favorable, as Mr. Bali has rightly said. Some schools on experimental basis they started, but have to close down because of cases. And let's wait for vaccine, at least. Let's wait for vaccine. But still, then a lot of things we have to do from all the stakeholders' side. Especially, I will be focusing upon the parents' role. My question is whether we are going to start school or not. It's not going to be a relief, maybe for a while, because this is where the challenge lies. When we open the school, this is where everybody has to work more hard than working now. Already, parents have taken the role of teachers. Right, they are helping out. One, they are doing wonderful job, and they are good mentors now, and they are communicators. They are guide, and the thing is that we are dealing with young people. It's okay, as Mr. Bali has said, we can bring students of the highest secondary or high school. We can bring to school, but still, we have to see. As a parent, we are all educators at the same time, we are parents. We have to see whether the school meets all the requirements. That means whether the school is able to follow all the protocols. Because we are playing with the lives of the young ones. Whether the school is, prepared enough to meet these challenges, these risks. If one is infected, of course the school has to, do a lot. And it will lead to closure as well. So, as a parent, we have to think twice. The survey says that 71% of parents do not want to send them to school now. Even I have taken survey in my school, 60% do not want. 40% want to send their children to school. And the age group belongs to kindergarten, then higher secondary. Kindergarten, parents feel difficult to manage their kids at home, so they want to send, but they have to think about the safety issues if they are much vulnerable to infection. So this is what I have to advise parents: do not rush, and we have a lot of responsibilities, and we have to share the responsibility. We have to communicate with the school. We have to get all the protocols from the school and communicate with the child. Each and every time we have to communicate with the child, communicate with the teacher, communicate with the school authority, and make sure the school is ready with all precautions, then we can think of sending. Even after sending, the child, the parents have to be after the child. That's why I said the responsibility increases more, because the parent has to check before sending the child. The parent has to check whether the child is suffering from any fever, any flu, or any type of such illness. Then let the parent keep the child at home. We can understand the parents' worries. You know, working parents especially, they are battling with their routine, their life, finding it difficult to manage the child at home and manage the work as well. But definitely then we have to, you know, combat this as well. But then we have to educate children about wearing a mask, social distance, keeping social distance, and one more thing, sanitization. Child has to carry sanitization. And children are very anxious about going to school now. We can understand their psychological needs and all. But this is where our responsibility, parents, teachers' responsibility lies. We have to sit with children and we have to educate. We have to slowly set their minds up in order to, you know, adapt themselves with the situation. Then we become so successful. The students will have traumas, will have mental issues, you know, psychological development issues, all these we are facing. We are not, you know, we don't have in-person schooling now. So these points we can take here, and also parents can have an important role, a right to go in the PTM. That is, a school can set up a PTC, that means parent teacher committee, especially for, you know, managing the situation. And parents can be invited to volunteer. So parents also will be available in school. They come with their children. A few of their parents volunteer in checkup of safety measures and all. They also conduct sessions for educating other parents. These are the better ways we can do. And if at all we are bringing children to school or higher school, we have to, as per protocol, we have to reduce the strength of children. Let us have blended learning. Right now, they are talking about reduction of syllabus. Let us be flexible in that term. We are conducting, you know, we are learning already. We are learning synchronous classes and asynchronous classes. You know, learning happens at home. So let us have a blended learning approach when the school reopens, and it's a collective responsibility. Not alone the parents, the school, the teachers, and the community workers as well. They have to join together and see that the school is safe and secure. And at the same time, the parents can also ask a few questions to themselves before sending their children to school. Whether what steps has the school taken to help ensure the safety of students? So, and how will the school support the mental health of students and combat any stigma against people who have been sick? And another thing is bullying. It's pretty sure that, you know, if a child who have already caught, you know, COVID, suppose if he is returning, these small children, they don't know. They may be making fun of him. The child undergoes another trauma. Bullying. So is there any such system in school?